Two arc survival evolved. I had leveled up. I forgot that we hadn't even learned the engrams to make the furniture. Well, the housing, I should say. So I went on and I killed a couple things. Mainly a dodo and a mega piranha because it was bugging me when I was trying to drink. But let's see, what do we want? We could do movement speed. That's pretty handy. Could do melee damage again. Let's do movement speed. A couple more points there. So we got 9 engram points. Okay. All we need to learn is the foundation, which is right here. I'm going to learn that one. And then... I was hoping to have enough. Next time I level up, though, I'm going to do something. Let's do the doorway and then the walls. And then next time, though, I'm going to do this. Mortar and pestle and spark powder. Because it's a nice, easy way to get some good, quick experience points. Because look at this. I've been picking rocks. And I got lots of rocks, lots of flint. I got some more in here. And I've just been picking rocks because you use 2 flint and a piece of stone. And you can turn it into spark powder. Well, every time you make spark powder, you get like 2 experience points. And then, if I have enough, I could even do... Well, let's check. Let's see, 6 for that. No, I don't have enough. You can make gunpowder next level. And then you use that spark powder with charcoal from cooking food all the time. And you can get even more experience points. So if you don't want to kill stuff, or you're not very good at killing stuff, there's always workarounds, so you can do that. So let's build some stuff. I have lots of resources here. Let's start with the foundation. In order to build pretty much anything at this point, you have to have the foundation down first. And then we're gonna want a door. And then a couple walls. Let's see. 2. I'm gonna do 4, because I'm gonna show you something. This is very cool about how the building works in this game. I quite like it. Whereas most games, it's kind of a pain to build sometimes. And I'll explain in 1 second. Where do we want to put this? We don't want to go too far that way. I kind of like this nice little clear spot. It's not going to be a big base. It's just mainly for us to put a bed down and demonstrate how the building works. And then also for storage. I don't know. You don't really need it. It's nice that you can put storage things on the ground. So we're going to stick it, if we decide to make it bigger, you can stick it about here. So there's your foundation. That's the most expensive part. Takes the most resources. Wood will take a lot more resources later on in place of the thatch. But here you go. So you built this. Now we can put down a little walls. So you see you can't put it anywhere. It has no snap points. So you just go and you put it right here. Bam. It snaps to it. You can build a wall. We can build another wall. And then we can build another wall. And then we can build... Oh, another wall. Oh, but wait. Oh no. We didn't put a doorway in. We're stuck. We can't get out. Oh no. You gotta break it down, right? No. I've played games where that happens. You build something, takes forever, and then you gotta break it because you put it in the wrong spot. Or it doesn't line up with something. It's a pain. Well, you can... I don't know if you can actually damage your own stuff. You can. You can damage your own stuff, but it's an easier, simpler way. You hover over it. You can repair it, or you can demolish it. You just hold that, and eventually it will just break. But another cool feature is, say we wanted to stay here, and we wanted to upgrade this to wood. Well, rather than just having to destroy every bit by bit, including the floor, all we do is say this is a wood wall we wanted in. We just hover it over where we want to replace, and bam, we did it. Now you see you added thatch and stuff? That's because you get half the resources you use to make whatever it is you just destroyed, which is another cool feature. So you get some stuff back for if you change your mind. It's pretty nice. Now I have to go find my bed. Oops. Okay. Was it this one? Yes, it is. So beds you have to put on foundations. You can do sleeping bags on the floor, but the trouble is then if you put them without a base, then they can't be destroyed. Now, trick is getting it in there. Bam. Very nice. Now we have a bed. We can respawn here indefinitely. The only bad side about dying in one bed is there's a respawn delay. Basically, I think it's 5 minutes. And if you die within that 5 minutes, you can't respawn in that bed as soon as you'd like to. So, to prevent that, do I have enough hides? I think I do. We do. So, I like to make what I call the backup bed. I'm going to do a sleeping bag because I don't feel like trying to make another bed. I don't think I had enough hides for it anyways. But you can place this anywhere you want. And basically it allows us to, in case we die and we're close to our base, and then we get there and we find our loot, and then we die again, we can't respawn anywhere without going to one of the starting respawn spots. I'm just going to stick this, like, I think I'm going to stick it right here. Where's our little campfire? I'm pretty sure I had a campfire here. Did you guys break it? Oh, there it is. It's invisible. Okay. Bam. Gonna put it right there. Yeah, there's an invisible campfire right here. It's kind of neat. and we're thirsty. So yeah, always, if you can, and you get into like a nice established place, just go for two sleeping bags, just so that you don't have to worry about that hassle. It's mainly if you want to get your loot back. Let me just jump over in the water. So we have quite a bit to go before we level up. I'm thinking I want to go after kill some stuff. And I might show you how I kill some things in the beginning here. When you don't have a bow. Bows are great, but they don't do a lot of damage. They're more for accuracy and distance. But they don't deal the much damage as spears do, which is their only downfall, really. They're very versatile. So, do I have enough spears? I have 4. I just dropped off my wood. Otherwise, on my flint. I'm gonna make... Well... Yeah, I want to make... Oh, no, wait, no, I got this pike. Oh, I completely forgot. Wait, no, 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 no. That's going to take forever to finally fix that. We're going to save the pike for emergency cases. Basically, if we're in, like, a die or flight situation and we have to go for the fight, we're going to use that. But right now, I want to save it and use spears as much as possible. So let's go quickly make some more. So let's see. I have all the resources. Bam. Bam, plus we get experience points for making this. Put all this stuff in here so I don't lose it. I don't need that. I don't need that on me. And I don't really need that many fibers to make a few spears. So there we go. 2, 3. There we go. 2 more. Armor's doing okay. This requires hide, so it's gonna wait. And there we go. Okay, stick this all in here. Very nice. Well, might as well if I can. There we go. Well, there's that little puppy. So you want at least, I'd say 7 spears. I mean, you could maybe do it with 5, but the thing you want... Oh, there's a Carnotaur. Right over there. Poking you, dude. Eh. Eh. Okay. Well, luckily we got this giant body of water between us. I mean, you don't want to deal with Carnotaurs right now. They are... I think I mentioned this. They are very quick. Is there anything in the water? I don't see anything. Piranhas always get me. Especially early stages when I don't have the health and armor that I'm used to. When I start a new character or decide to join, do something else. Go in no direction. Start fresh on another side of the island. There's a Bronto. Where'd he go? Well, there you are. So, these guys... Very, very quick. You cannot outrun them. They are so quick. This one, oh, lucky us, is level 1. He is near a lot of water, which is kind of where you sometimes want to do it. Basically, you get your spears, charge them up, and you just throw them right in their faces, and then kind of angle it, try to figure out where they're going to... God, you serpentine so much. Like a pro. And you just basically gotta get lucky. And see, we're all out of spears already. Dang you! You made me miss like 2 of them. Okay. See, he's just too quick. The only thing we can hope is he turns around or he gets stuck someplace. Because I'm gonna run out of energy any second. This thing has good range, but I don't. Not that far. Come on, stop running! Stop it! Stop it! There we go, I got him in the butt. That wasn't the best example. I was hoping he'd actually run into the water. Because that's their only downfall. Most dinosaurs, when they get into water, slow down incredibly. So that's when you want to just start chucking spears right in their backsides. I'm going to go for some hides here, since I just used a bunch, and we need to repair our armor. And we want to start saving up, because when we reach level 15, we can make hide armor, which is twice as good as cloth armor. It just requires a lot of hides and fiber. Well, not so much fiber, but mainly hides. Yeah, there's so much cool stuff you get. Level 10's decent. It's more for structures. Like, there's the wooden walls and foundations. Irrigation for farming. I forget what we can train at level 10. It's been a while. A compass, I think. Who needs a compass? Alright, so we're out here. We're going to grab a couple bit more wood. And eat the last of our meat. And that's it. I usually don't go for the water sack. That's why I keep going in the water. It's kind of... I like to save those ingram points in the beginning for some nice, cool stuff. I can always find water, usually, because in the beginning you don't want to venture too far from the water, because that means you're going into a lot better lands. Now, I only have one spear left. Do I? I think there was a fish in here we can go after. Are you fishy? I thought I saw one. He's gone now. Alright, let's go back home. Let's cook the meat we got. I've been storing it also on my thing because, if I remember correctly, level 15 is when we can train a raptor. No, I shouldn't say that. When we can ride a raptor, I think it is. You can get a saddle for one. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah, you can tame anything. I'm pretty sure I mentioned this too. You can tame anything if you have the will. It's just a matter of your tools you have at hand and your determination and luck. Lots and lots of luck. I don't go after turtles. They're too hard. There are too many spears break on them. Okay. Let's run a little bit more. I'll cook up some food. I like this cave, though. It's very cool. Okay. Who got the meat? Oh my goodness, you guys are so gassy. Actually, I'm gonna take four of those. I already got some cooked meat on me. You hold on to that. That's about it. This guy got all my berries. Oh, you're leveled up. Let's do your health. I got 36 points now. 236. And my campfire is no longer invisible. Sweet. I'm gonna use thatch. Because I got lots of thatch now. I went a little crazy with the pickaxe on the trees. Okay. And we're gonna need that. Get rid of that. Make some more spears. We need them, and it's good experience points. How many can we make? 9? Sweet. I'm kind of feeling like going down the beach again. There is... Oops. We're already out of thatch in the fire. Okay, got one piece cooked. Light that up. Okay. And we need that. Put that back on the hot bar. These only stack up to 10. Eventually I will probably start carrying like 20 of them. No, not 20. 15. One time I had to take out a carno and it took about almost 20 spears to kill it. I just sat on this rock because it was like near my home base. So it was like, every time I go down there to drink some water, it would kill me. So I was like, I'm going to show you. So I sat on a rock, and I just harpooned it like crazy. Okay. Let's cook up this last piece. And... any second here? There we go. Put that out. Save the thatch. You had the meat. Now I'm going to leave these guys here because mainly I'm using them for storage and they're not the fastest. And I can replace whatever I lose. I only have, you know, I got a slingshot with one shot in it. I don't know why I got that. Well, in case we tame something. I can always find rocks. But I don't want to lose them right now because they're more handy as storage than as companions. And I don't need them for guard dogs because there's nothing out here really. This is a pretty decent spot. I haven't seen anything big. I don't think I've even seen a raptor up here, but I know there's some down the beach here. Along with some more scorpions, possibly. Because I tamed... When was this? A while back, I was down here at this water spot. I think I mentioned this, but I'm sorry if I repeat myself, but I can't remember which I've said before. Down here on this beach is a decent spot if you want to kind of, like, get into the taming area. Like, I found raptors down here. I found a carno once. I found scorpions. And, let's see, triceratopses. I think I found a stego once. There's a big variety of animals down here. But it's mainly the meat-eater ones that I like to come down here. Oh, there's a raptor, I think, over there. Or it's something, a pterosaur, maybe. Okay. There's a turtle climbing that rock like a pro. Seriously, how did you even get up there, dude? If we can find a scorpion, we might be able to find some really good loot. Okay, what was that? That's a trike, okay. I thought that was a big crocodile. Oh, look at this dude. Hello. Oop. I like that green shell. Looks cool. I love the turtles. Well, generally all the dinosaurs. They look so cool, and their color schemes, like, you can find some. I'm looking for, like, Bowser, basically. Orange skin with, like, what is it? Green or black? I want to say it's green. Oh, shoot. What's that? Green or black shell. But I haven't found that one yet. I want to say... Oh, shit. There's a raptor. I don't know if I want to take on a raptor right now. Let's eat. Oh, I'm dehydrated. Okay. I don't know if I want to take on a raptor right now. I think I could take it. Like I said, this thing has amazing range. Even if you don't think you're hitting it, you are in fact hitting it, and it also has a little bit of a knockback. Very nice. I've used so many pikes. I finally got into the caves I mentioned before, and I own this one cave. It's a very nice basic cave. I'm going to show on the map real quick. If you go down there where that little marker says cave, we're eventually going to head there, but we need to train up before we even bother going for that trip. But if you get down there, it's a nice starting cave. The bad guys in it, it's not too bad. It's mainly scorpions, spiders, and snakes. Not too bad. Where did he go? You don't want to get caught off guard by a raptor. I think he went over across the water, actually. Because I don't see him now. Nope, there he is. Hello. Oh, we're level one. I got you. I got you. Oh. Okay, that was close. I don't recommend going after raptors with a slingshot. Not at all. I will show you one place, though, real quick while we're here. There's this little cliff. That's why I kind of came here. It's very nice. There's rocks. There's different things. You never know what you're going to find here. Right over there. You see that little cliff? There's this one spot. Let me kill this Dilo real quick. Give me Mr. Dilo. I know we need a Mo, but I'm saving it in case we go on a long trip and we lose all of our Dios. Then I can get Mo and all the others together again. Right here. You see this little cliff? Or there's this rock here. And I ended up, you see, I'm running right into it. And this is a good test to see if a raptor can get you. Is you can run right into it and you can't get up here. And I was up on top of this other side of this. And I kid you not, I got two raptors right there with trank arrows, of course. But there was two of them trying to get me and I got them both. It was pretty cool. Let's see if there's anything up here we can go. I've got a little bit of time left. We're going to take a little peek. Oh, yeah, we've been here before. I forgot. I've shown this spot. Let's just take a little peek, though. I just love the views from these places. This island is huge. It's really huge. Okay, there's a stego. And that's about it. But, yeah. Oh, there's another stego. Nice. But, yeah, let's see. I've been on that mountain. It's very tall. Lots and lots of metal on it. I've never been to that far one. I've mainly, as you've noticed on my map, I've only stuck to mainly the south. As far as it goes, that mountain in the middle, That was when I was flying over it, because there was a supply drop I really, really wanted. But other than that, I've been mainly in the south, and I've been a little bit to the east, I guess. But yeah, there we go. I'm going to end here. We're going to... I don't know. I'm going to do a little off-camera killing and stuff. See if we can level up a little bit more. Get some more engrams. And I will show you how to do the spark powder stuff. It's very handy. And I will see you guys next time.